The VMEA show is sponsored by the following people. Hello and welcome to a VMEA show, entering your homes via Channel 4, Shaw TV. This show has been recently reformatted from a radio version and it's making its TV debut right now. My name is Mia and I have to say within those few years living here in Canada, I've met a lot of great people. They taught me to see the world a little bit different and I think a little better. And I would like you to meet some of those people. For today, my special guest, magician, illusionist, Vitaly Beckman. Vitaly, thank you very much for accepting my invitation today.
Thank you so much, Mia, for having me. It's an honor and a privilege to be your first guest on the show.
Well, just be careful, we haven't even started yet.
If I may, I'd like to make a prediction, right? Of the start.
Prediction, that's
yes,
something.
Yes, I predict that this show, your show, is going to be very successful and it's going to have a long run. And
I think
it's recorded.
I've seen some of your predictions. This is so far the nicest one. I hope this is going to work like any previous ones. Vitaly, before I give you space, what you really deserve, I picked a few headlines from the newspaper, if you don't mind. I found only the good ones.
So. Sure.
For example, inspires wonder. The Vancouver Sun, jaw-dropping show, The Province, blows minds, The Vancouver Courier. Just tell me, what really makes you to blow our minds?
Well, I don't really, it's not about blowing people's minds. It's about sharing wonder. It's about sharing my vision of the world, of wonder with an audience. It's not about, you know, blowing minds.
Well, I'm just picking on those words, what I just saw here. Let's take it from beginning because that's how everything starts, right? At the beginning. And you had one too. How was it for you when you started? What was your start like, or beginning like?
I started when I was in high school. I saw David Copperfield show on television.
Oh.
And he did this amazing grand scale magic. He made trains disappear, airplanes, you know? But he did one small thing with two rubber bands that got me really fascinated. And I tried to figure it out for days and I couldn't. I just set them on the table and I thought, you know, how would I do it? I don't know how he does it, but how would I do it? And I tried and it worked. And I showed my family and they liked it.
But yes. that was your first trick,
That
right?
was the very first one, yeah.
Okay, and who was your audience at that time?
Yeah, my family were the very, my mom was the very first one. But you know, moms are always nice, no matter what you show them. Mm-hmm. But I showed it to, I showed it to my brother. Brothers are not always nice. And I showed it to my friends, and mm-hmm. they all liked it. Mm-hmm. But then they all wanted to see more. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to show more.
Yeah.
So I came up with more ideas and ways to accomplish them.
Yeah.
And this is what I do till this very day. In fact, everything I do in my live shows and in the shows I'll be doing this month, it all comes from my own imagination. So,
well, sorry, I have to interrupt
yes,
you because
yes.
now you really got me intrigued. So you talk nicely, but I'd like to see something. So
sure.
What was your first first trick? I know you don't really like that word. We'll get to that later.
Okay.
Would you be able to demonstrate?
Yeah, actually, you know, I thought it would be appropriate to show the very first thing I learned.
Okay.
And I've got the rubber bands with me.
That's
just
what you showed to your
yes,
parents.
Yes, yes. Just two rubber bands and two fingers. And I'm just gonna, interlock them like that. I don't know if you can see that.
Well, yeah, I can see very well.
Okay, then I cannot escape in any direction. But if I rub them like that.
Okay, then, and what?
Do you see they separated?
No, I just see them suddenly separated, yeah.
Yeah.
And it, yes.
So it's, you see that every day?
No, I don't.
I'm just kidding. Actually, can I try this with you, Mia?
Sure.
Just point your fingers like this, two fingers like two guns, and I'll ask you to bend. Bend one finger.
Okay.
And bend the other one like this.
Yeah.
So they're kind of stretched.
Okay.
Now this time.
I don't know if anybody see me?
Okay. Oh, yeah. We've got this on camera. And this rubber band, we're going to put behind, just like that, you see? And you can close the thumbs, so it cannot go through there.
All right.
And I'll try to show it to here.
Well, I guess I'm a magician too.
You too, yes. You can, you can take this, yeah. You can practice
souvenir.
At home as well. Souvenir.
Oh, well, you bet I will.
So that was the
Another
very first thing
night.
I learned.
Okay, so this, among the other, you know, you don't like the word trick. We already talked about it. You prefer the word illusion. So what is the difference between trick and illusion?
The difference is in how it makes the audience feel. I think trick, to me, it's more intellectual. It's like a puzzle. Somebody watched that, he can scratch his head, like, huh, how did he do that? Illusion, or what I do on stage, it's more theatrical. I entertain the audience. I transport them to another place, a place where anything is possible. And I try to convey sensation of wonder. And that's the name of the show, Sensation of Magic.
That's right.
Because it's not about tricking somebody. Mm-hmm. It's about sharing wonder, which is different.
Yeah, for sure. Vitaly, I mean, the performance you showed, you forwarded, you moved forward. Much more now these days. I saw you performing, and Vitaly's performance is absolutely amazing. I saw it a couple of weeks ago. We can see a little more. Something is coming up, right?
Yes. I just got back from a tour in the Lower Mainland. Mm-hmm. And this month, the last two shows in North Vancouver on May 18, 19. And that's
at
the Presentation
upcoming...
House in North Vancouver.
Okay.
That's the upcoming shows, yeah.
So Vitaly's upcoming show is 18, 19 May, which is in just a couple of weeks from now. And I'm sure that you can be seen, and all this information can be seen on his website, which is sensationofmagic.com. We can see it right there. And you said that you like to interact with the audience.
Yes. Now, you've been to the show. You've seen a big portion of the show is about interacting with the audience, involving them.
Yeah.
So the magic is not only happening on stage, something they watch, it happens in the entire theater, and people become part of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought maybe I can involve you here today. Is that okay?
Can you
stand up?
I can stand up. Right. I don't know if you realize you have the biggest audience now ever.
Oh, well, I'm not sure about that.
I'm sure you do. Like, you have 30, 40,000 viewers.
That's okay.
I don't think you had that many people in the audience. Okay.
Oh, not live. Live. Yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm. But, you know, unfortunately, you cannot share the same performance on TV as you can live. Unfortunately, it doesn't translate the same way on television. But we're going to try.
Yeah.
We're going to do something with this package of gum. But first, I need to prepare you. Could you rub your hands together like this?
Sure.
And shake them up. Good. Take a deep breath. Good. Now hold your left hand like this, and your right hand above it, just like that. So, do you feel some kind of a connection between your hands?
None.
Heat or something? Mm-mm. Hold them closer.
Not at all.
Imagine, okay?
Oh, okay.
Imagine there's a connection. So maybe something. Just imagine.
Oh,
it.
I feel something there now.
You don't have to. If you don't feel, that's fine.
No,
I need you to imagine it. Use your imagination, okay? I want you to go along with me in your mind. You don't have to really believe it. Okay, now I'm going to put this package of gum, I'm going to hold it between your hands.
Okay.
Imagine there's a connection that's going through the package, okay? Okay, and I'll ask you to hold it like that, closer to me. And rotate this hand slightly, just like so. Mm-hmm. You're going to rotate it, but imagine there is a connection. If you don't imagine, it's not going to work, okay?
Connection between my hand and the gum.
Your hands and the package.
Wow.
Okay, now rotate it slowly, and the other hand as well.
But slower, slower, Mia, slower. And imagine there's a connection. Watch. It's happening. Keep going. Keep doing it. I don't know if we can get this on camera.
Yeah, the package is moving.
It's moving. Excellent, excellent.
That wasn't bad for a start. That wasn't bad.
Maybe I wasn't imagining enough, right?
You'll get better. Now, let's try this again. This time, this hand's gonna push, the other one's gonna pull.
All right.
So let's try it. This hand, but you have to use your imagination to feel the connection. Pull, try again. Pull.
I'm pulling the package.
Very good, it's working.
Oh my God.
It's working. Now, one finger only. One finger, hold it like this. Mia, you're gonna move it in this direction. You understand?
I understand.
Okay. Slowly. No, let's start one more time. Slowly. Move it in this direction again.
What's happening? Oh my God.
Can the camera get that? Can the camera get that? Yeah. It's opening. Now. Grab, hold on to this, grab it, take it out, and for the most important part, Mia, have a gum.
So, I don't know, I would like to clap, but can I sit down?
Oh, you don't have to clap, yeah absolutely.
I'm not going to ask you how you do this.
You did it, Mia, it's you, you were doing the thing.
I did it.
Yes.
It's just, I don't understand, because I saw your performance before. I mean, I was sitting so close to Vitaly. I was watching you so carefully. You just put another sleepless night to my life, because I guess that's what you're supposed to do, challenge people's mind, right?
Again, it's not about challenging. It's about making you experience wonder. Just like when we are children and everything is wondrous in the world, you know, that's kind of the same sensation.
I like the word wonder. I do.
Yeah.
You know, when you started this show, predicting how my show and how everything will go, why don't we go to March 21st?
Okay.
This year? March 21st, you decided to do something very unusual, something I've never seen in my life. You decided to predict an event supposed to happen 3 weeks later.
Yes.
And we actually have it with us, this box. I don't know which one is taking. Yeah, this box. There was an audio tape sealed in it, which Vitaly predicted his news, what's going to happen on April 10th. It was locked on a chain. Chain was locked, and it was hung in a restaurant in Vancouver.
And you had the key.
I had a key.
You had the key. You and another reporter, there were two keys,
this
two locks.
This key was holding the chain and was locked.
You still have it.
And I still have it. The key was with me for 3 weeks, and so Vitaly had absolutely no access to it. And well, let's see what was happening, actually, before we carry on with the conversation. What happened on March 21st? So that was just the beginning. That was the March 21st. And if Vitaly really succeeded, I mean, the reveal is going to be revealed after this short break.
Via Mia Show is sponsored by the following people.
Yes, so this photo was happening on March 21st. Nobody knew if Vitaly is going to succeed or not. There were five news you decided to predict. And
there were four. There were four.
Four.
I think I failed on the weather.
And who doesn't?
Yeah, I thought it's going to rain.
Yeah,
but
okay.
Yeah, the other four, I think it was very close. Very,
okay.
Yeah.
Well, just guide us a little bit before we show the reveal, what was happening on April.
Well, yes, you were part of the committee with okay. some reporters. They all removed the box, and your key unlocked the locks. They opened it, mm-hmm. and they listened to the tape. And we can show it.
That's right. We synchronized it with...
Yeah, we don't have the whole thing, but...
Yeah, let's see it. It worked. I don't know how you did it, but not only that, Vitaly didn't only predict what is happening 3 weeks after his prediction, he also added a little bonus at the end. I never know which one is taking me. A news reporter, she was standing right there, Cynthia Ramsey, and I, we were actually predicted what we're gonna wear. Vitaly was reading it right there.
I predicted it, but you were
reading it.
It was in the keychain.
Yeah.
The one yes. that you have, she also had a keychain, and inside the keychain, I placed another prediction when the box was hanged.
Mm-hmm.
And she carried it for 3 weeks with her. She didn't know inside her keychain there was a prediction of what she and you are going to wear that day.
Yeah.
3 weeks later, and she. And
that's absolutely
amazing. We have that on video on my website if anybody wants to see that.
Yeah, so we would just have to go back to sensationofmagic.com, which is Vitaly's website. It will reveal all the stuff except that how we did the prediction. That's not going to be revealed there.
There's nothing to reveal there.
Exactly, nothing to reveal. I know there is something else, Vitaly, about you you do differently than your fellow workers. There is something that separates you from
I think everything I do in my shows, I try to make it different and unique to me because I create my own magic. But there is one thing in particular that I became known for and from my live shows. And perhaps I can, I don't know, I'm not sure if you have time to actually show it here, but maybe some of it, just a bit.
We have
time. Is that okay? Yeah,
we will have time.
Do you mind standing up again?
Are we standing up? Okay.
Yes. And we're going to, can we have a deck of cards, please? Thank you. And Mia, I'm going to show you first. I've got a deck of playing cards. Can you see that? Yeah. And I'm going to just ask you to hold your finger like this. Good. And just place it. I'm going to go with the card like this. Just place it on any of the cards. Doesn't matter which one.
I'm attaching.
Just tap one. Yeah. Oh, this one right here?
Yeah.
Are you sure? It's a free choice.
Very much.
Just remember it, please.
Okay. Yeah.
Yes. Don't forget it. I hope the camera can see it as well. And hold it against yourself, just like that. Okay?
Yeah.
Hold it against yourself. Mm-hmm. You see, the thing I became known for mm-hmm. is for doing amazing things with photographs. And on a recent trip to London, everywhere I went, I took a picture of myself holding a playing card. Everywhere, a different playing card in my hand. And I think you'll find this amazing because I've got the photographs with me here. For example, this is the London Eye, and I'm holding the Jack of Clubs. And I had a big deck of cards there, Mia.
I can tell.
Yes, and here I'm at the Tower Bridge, and that's the Ace of Hearts.
Mm-hmm.
I had a lot of fun there, as you can see. A lot of photographs and a lot of playing cards. But only the last one is important, because the last photograph, Mia, is where I'm holding your playing card. What is your card? Can you tell us all?
It's seven Yeah, I should show.
Yes, it's what? Seven of hearts. Seven of hearts.
I
now,
need to see it.
Perfect. Here it is. The last photograph in London. I'm holding the seven of hearts. I don't know if you can see it there.
Yeah.
Can you? Or
I can't.
You can't? There's a lot of traffic there, Mia.
I can tell.
Yes, yes. But I definitely remember holding it there.
Okay.
Maybe you can see it behind the bus or behind the... No?
No, it's
no?
still not convincing.
Not convincing? Well, I can go back and retake that photograph, but I'll try to show it to you.
Great.
Okay? Just listen, Mia. Listen. Did you hear that?
Yes.
Yeah? Listen again. Listen one more time. Did you hear that?
Yes.
One last time, last time. Listen, listen.
Look, where is that coming from? It's definitely a lot of traffic. I can't believe this.
Now share your card to the camera. Which photo is that?
There it is.
And Mia, that's the seven of hearts right here. And I want you to hold this. I'm gonna take it out for you. And I want you to have a look. Check it out. Is this a regular photograph, Mia? Is it?
It is, yeah.
It is. And it's for you. It's a souvenir.
It's mine?
It's yours.
I'm taking so much stuff with me today.
Yes.
What about this card?
You can take the card too.
Okay, Vitaly, I can't really say anything about this because I'm standing I'm speechless. I'm standing right beside you. You said you do something else.
Yes, I'm not sure if we have
time. We probably won't have time, but let's like to say what I saw Vitaly doing on his performance, very similar to this. He simply took two pictures or one picture and he removed the object from the picture.
From the photograph.
From the photograph. And the reason I'm saying this, from there. Reason I'm saying this that Vitaly's performance coming up May 18 and 19.
Yeah.
You
yes.
you encourage people
yes.
to bring their picture.
Their pictures to the to the live show.
He can remove the unwanted objects. You know, any objects you don't feel like having there. Just make sure that the person who's gonna be removed, it's not dear to you because it won't be brought back.
It might be forever altered.
Yes.
Yes. In the show, if I may add, what I do, I have several pictures,
mm-hmm.
and people examine them and even sign their names on the photographs, and I move one person from a picture to another one.
Yes.
And so forth. And people move from one photograph to another. And I'm going to try for the first time, I'm going to try to do it this month on May 18. There are going to be two shows, but it's on May 18th that I'm encouraging the audience to bring their own photographs to the show. And I'm going to attempt to do that with photographs I have never seen before. So, yeah.
Okay.
So, please bring your photographs.
Okay, please bring your photographs. But again, as we said, that not the pictures that you like to remain as they are with people you like, because pictures won't be able to be altered. That's right?
Might be not, yes.
Yeah, might be not. You know, Vitaly, I knew that a half hour with you, it's not going to be enough. So time flies, but I'd like to ask you one more question. When we talk about the prediction, I'm still thinking about it. The most popular worldwide topic, what is going to actually happen December 21st this year?
Oh.
You know, the famous ending of the world, so.
Yes. December 21st. It's going to be, Mia.
Yes.
A Friday. And it's also going to be a very short day. That's all I can tell you about it.
Well, Vitaly, let me tell you something. If this is what the prediction takes, I mean, I can join the club because, okay, for those who didn't get that long information and it was not clear, it's going to be the shortest Friday. That's what...
Yeah, it's going to be 1 hour shorter, yeah. And
well, yeah, so this and any other information Vitaly very gladly provide through his website, sensationofmagic.com. You can also Facebook him. You're
yes,
a very
yes.
friendly man, so he can take you as a friend anytime and chat with you if he's got time. He doesn't have much, but... yeah, and Maybe I have just a few seconds to ask you, if you don't mind. I know, as we talked about before, you started somehow many years ago.
Yes.
Is there anything you would like to share with people that are standing in your shoes? Not literally, but let's say that they would like to become you, or they recognize the talent you have, and maybe some heads up, some guideline.
Well, as far as magic goes, what I would say for people who want to get into magic is to try to think, what would you like to share with an audience? And try to rely on your own imagination and creativity, and to come up with the ways to, the solutions, the ways to achieve what you want to share, to perform. I would say to avoid a little bit of seeking answers elsewhere, like not to seek ready-made answers, mm-hmm. and it's not just for people who want to get into magic, you know, for anybody who wants to succeed in anything. I think the greatest solutions to where we want to go can be found within our own mind. And it's like Arthur William Ward, I think, said, if you can imagine it, you can achieve it. And I think imagination plus action, that's a good formula to success. It's not 100% formula, but it can work.
That's great. Vitaly Beckman, and Vitaly, before you go, I mean, please stay with me just for a few seconds, because you have two more tasks to do. Again, we can find Vitaly on thesensationofmagic.com. I want to really thank you for sharing the information, for your time, and that you said yes.
Well, thank you. Great being here. Thank you so much, Mia.
Yeah, that was a great experience to have you here.
It was wonderful being here.
I think that's it for today. We will, before we go, I would like to ask you something.
Oh,
I'm going to reach for something here. So as you saw, you were drinking from this cup, but this one is going to be special for you to sign and from whoever is going to follow you.
Thank you.
And if I find my pen. So you as a first guest, if you don't mind to sign it
sign?
For me. Yes.
Oh, sure.
And I also would like you to sign my keys, because this key is from you. Oh my, thank you so much. Thank you very much. What a beautiful surprise. I'll leave some space for others, please.
Oh, well, I'm the first.
Because you don't want to tell me your first and last on my show, right?
Oh, I didn't know,
right?
All right.
And this key is from you, so if you don't mind.
Sure.
And I think we're right.